I'm Lieutenant Karen McCallum. I've been in the Navy now for 9.5 years. I joined and went through ADFA to get my degree, the Defence Force Academy, as an aeronautical engineer. Since then I've worked on Seahawks and now I'm working on Sea Kings, and I'm a safety engineer and quality officer. So I do a lot of investigations and things into what goes wrong and find out how to improve things at the squadron, which is really good because that was kind of what I got into engineering for in the first place. I wanted to be an engineer, but I was working more at mechanical engineering, and my brother went to an ad for open day and I just kind of tagged along. Once I met some of the aeronautical engineers there and they showed me what they do, I'm like, wow, that's so much more interesting than being a mechanical engineer. I could fix cars or I could fix helicopters. In our engineering degree, you kind of do fixed wing for most of it, and then the last year or year and a half, you actually look into rotary wing, so into all sorts of helicopters. Once you finish that degree and you come to Albatross, you find out a bit more about whichever specific aircraft you're going to be working on. I did my training time on Seahawks, and you get taught a lot about that aircraft at that time. But engineers, unlike everybody else in aviation, we actually don't specialise in an aircraft type. So we get to change it up a lot, which is really good. You can go from Seahawks to posting over and working on Squirrels or Sea Kings, or when the MRH-90 come in. The helicopters that we work on are just so complicated and interesting, and it's just completely different to what you would do in the civilian world. There's basically three different types of jobs we can do as an engineer. The first one that you usually do is exactly this, working directly on the aircraft itself, and doing people management, looking after the technicians and doing the hands-on work. There's also design jobs, so we do the number crunching, real engineering, in-depth engineering work. So there's, yeah, an opportunity to kind of work on the aircraft, and then as you progress through your career, you can influence the future as well. We're a pretty strong team. All of the aeronautical engineers, both weapons electrical engineers and aeronautical engineers, all in all we're about 70 or 80, so we're a pretty small team, and so we work together pretty closely and everyone knows everyone. We're all very different. There's no particular type of person that becomes an engineer, except that you have an interest in helicopters, I guess, and you want to improve. The reward that you get when you see your aircraft up there flying is really cool.